So we will be looking at land resources and agriculture. So in this chapter, if you see, the first thing that I should start with is this topic where it talks about net zone area, and then it talks about fallow land and current fallow and current fallow. So first thing that we should see is current fallow. So what is current fallow? If you look at this carefully, you will find that it says that current fallow is an area which is left without agriculture for less than 1 year. Very good. So any area which is left without agriculture for 1 year is called as current fallow. Then comes the next word which you should concentrate on, that is fallow other than current fallow. What does it say? This is the area which is left without agriculture for more than 1 year but less than 5 years. So 1 to 5. So current fallow is 0 to 1, right? Other than current fallow is 1 to 5, and more than 5 is culturable wasteland. It says any land. Now you look at the sixth point. It says any land left fallow for more than 5 years is included in this category. It can be brought under cultivation after improving it through reclamation processes. So culturable wasteland. Understood. So what have I done? I have done 3 points just now. One is net zone, sorry, current fallow, then fallow other than current fallow, and the third is culturable wasteland. Okay, this much understood. Then we come to the net zone area, area in which agriculture is done throughout the year, and it is actual area. ठीक है, one is net, other is cultivated. Okay, so with this we look at the other point, which is point three. Look at the word barren in your books. This is on the screen also. If you look at the barren and the wasteland, these are the lands which are where no agriculture can be done. For this, the word is dir. D for desert land, A for arid land, R for ravines. Okay, so if you remember the word dir, you can understand barren and wasteland. All right, so now we come to the next important topic. There's a question that will come in the paper, a very important question, and I am focusing on this question. And the question is, look here, and that is, the question will come like this: explain about the land use changes in India. Okay, land use changes in India. So what are the land use changes? There are three land use changes. The first land use is changes, size of the economy changes. What does it say is that the size of the economy becomes bigger and bigger, है ना? With passage of time, what happens is economy grows, people become richer, so size of the economy grows. Then the second point that we look here is the composition of economy changes. Now, how does the composition of economy changes? Please look at this. It says that there are three parts of economy. One is primary, secondary, and tertiary. With the passage of time, people dependence on secondary and tertiary starts increasing. Agriculture will be a part of primary. Very good. And secondary and tertiary will start increasing. So this is the composition of economy is changing from primary economy. The economy will become secondary and tertiary. And the third change is contribution of agricultural activities. You know, there's a method in which if you want to draw a line and make it smaller than the other, than another line, you can draw another line longer than that. The first line becomes smaller. In play, if I say make this line smaller, and if you draw another line bigger than that, the line becomes smaller. The same thing happens with agriculture. Agriculture's contribution is still there. But what happens that secondary and tertiary sector start producing more. So that thing is being told in the third point. It says that agriculture and its contribution starts increasing, but in GDP it starts declining. Why? Because a large number of people are now not dependent on agriculture. They are dependent on primary and secondary activities. So number of people dependent on agriculture becomes less, but people employed in agriculture are still more. Okay, Yes. So with this we can say you have answered two questions. One is land use changes as well as you have also understood the categories. Thank you.